أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Continuing with our series on Ramadan, today we come to another beautiful hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, which is narrated by Abu Huraira, which says من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه وَمَنْ قَامَ رَمَضَانْ إِيمَانًا وَاحْتِسَابًا غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ. This beautiful, this part of hadith is beautiful hadith. It's telling us how wide and how great the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time, and especially in Ramadan. This is the time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us you have chances to get forgiven all your sins, all your previous sins, if you do things sincerely and solely for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those who would fast, only seeking the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those who would stand in prayers, seeking the pleasure and the acceptance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they will be forgiven. It's a guarantee, it's a security. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us here that Allah will forgive us all our sins. Allah's mercy is so great, so wide, all the time. And especially in Ramadan, as the Prophet ﷺ is telling us. Allah would forgive us all our previous sins, as in this hadith. All our previous sins, yes indeed. But the Prophet ﷺ also tells us in another hadith that the daily five prayers and the Jum'ah and Ramadan, in between, Allah would forgive us all our sins, all our previous sins, as long as we avoid major sins. Majtunibatil kabair. The major sins would require special repentance, special arrangements from us, special efforts from us to fix as much as we can and to repent to Allah sincerely and solely. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Ramadan is giving us time to fix our shortfalls and come to Him willingly, so He would forgive us all our sins. Also, another important note here. Ramadan is time to elevate ourselves in the scale of obedience, of obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Throughout the year, before Ramadan, we abstain from haram. This is for granted. This is guaranteed. In Ramadan, on top of that, we come to abstain from halal. So it's another addition to discipline ourselves and to control ourselves. This is the very important part of fasting, very apparent. Listen here, is that we need to elevate ourselves in the scale of self-restraint and self-control. And this is what Ramadan is doing to us, what fasting is doing to us, is to make sure we control our own desires and our own selves, so we come out of Ramadan much stronger spirits and bodies to meet the challenges of this world, to come out of Ramadan so we can change the evils of this in this world around us to a better, to something better, to enjoy good and to forbid evil, to have this strength to do that, so we can do that with all ourselves. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us Ramadan, or fasting time, so we can prepare ourselves for that. Plus, it's a time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving us to seek His forgiveness, so He can forgive us all our sins. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from all of us our fasting and our prayers and our acts of obedience in Ramadan and outside of Ramadan. May Allah give us strength in Ramadan, so we can meet more challenges afterwards. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Wa salli Allahumma wa barik ala Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.